Patem Salmagundi Part 2. Thanksgiving in the colonies was a matter of almost yearly occurrence. Since the first Thanksgiving Day on American shores, when, in 1621, the Massachusetts colony, at the request of Governor Bradford, rejoiced, after a special manner after we had gathered the fruit of our labors, the observance of days of thanksgiving for mercies and benefits had been frequent. But the day itself dates still further back. The states of Holland, after establishing their freedom from Spain, had, in the year 1609, celebrated their deliverance from tyranny by thanksgiving and hearty prayers, and had thus really first instituted the custom of an official thanksgiving. And the Dutch colonists in America followed the customs of the fatherland quite as piously and fervently as did the English colonists. So, when the proclamation of the Heer Governor Stuyvesant for a day of thanksgiving was made known, in this year of mercies, 1659, all the townfolk of New Amsterdam made ready to keep it. But young people are often apt to think that the world moves for them alone. The boys of this little Dutch town at the mouth of the Hudson were no different from other boys, and cared less for treaties and Indians and boundary questions than for their own matters. They, therefore, concluded that the Heer Governor had proclaimed a thanksgiving because, as young Patem Onderdink declared, he had gotten well rid of Dominie Curtius and would have no more schoolmasters in the colony, and so, lads, cried the exuberant young Knickerbocker, let us wisely celebrate the thanksgiving. I will even ask the mother to make for me a rare Salmagundi which we lads, who were so rated by the Heer Governor, will ourselves give to him as our thanksgiving offering, for the Heer Governor. So folk do say, doth rarely like the Salmagundi. Now the Salmagundi was, to some palates, a most appetizing mixture, compounded of salted mackerel, or sometimes of chopped meat, seasoned with oil and vinegar, pepper and raw onions, not an altogether attractive dish to read of, but welcome to and dearly loved by many an old Knickerbocker even up to a recent date. Its name, too, as most of you bright boys and girls doubtless know, furnished the title for one of the works of Washington Irving, best loved of all the Knickerbockers. Thanksgiving Day came around, and so did Patem's Salmagundi, as highly seasoned and appetizing a one as the good Vrouw Onderdink could make. The lengthy prayers and lengthier sermon of good Dominie Megapolensis in the Fort Church were over and the Thanksgiving dinners were very nearly ready when up to the Heer Governor's house came a half dozen boys, with Patem Onderdink at their head bearing a neatly covered dish. Patem had well considered and formed in his mind what he deemed just the speech of presentation to please the Heer Governor, but when the time came to face that awful personage his valor and his eloquence alike began to ooze away. And, it must be confessed, the Heer Governor Stuyvesant did not understand boys, nor did he particularly favor them. He was hasty and overbearing though high-minded, loyal, and brave, but he never could get on with the ways and pranks of boys. And as for the boys themselves, when once they stood in the presence of the greatest dignitary in the province, Patem's ready tongue seemed to cleave to the roof of his mouth, and he hummed and hawed and hesitated until the worthy Heer Governor lost patience and broke in. Well, well, boys, what is the stir? Speak quick if at all, for when a man's dinner waiteth he hath scant time for stammering boys, then Patem spoke up. Heer Governor, he said, the boys hereabout, remembering your goodness in sending away our most pestilential master, the Dominie Curtius, and in proclaiming a thanksgiving for his departure and for the ending of our schooling, what, boy, cried the Heer Governor, art crazy then, or would you seek to make sport of me, your governor? Thanksgiving for the breaking up of school. Out on you for a set of malapert young knaves. Do you think the world goeth but for your pleasures alone? Why, this is ribald talk. I made no thanksgiving for your convenience, rascals, but because that the Lord in his grace hath relieved the town from danger, of which, Heer Governor, broke in the most impolitic Patem, we did think the Dominie Curtius and his school were part. And so we have brought to you this Salmagundi as our thanksgiving offering to you for thus freeing us of a pest and a sorrow. How now, sirrah, again came the interruption from the scandalized Heer Governor when he could recover from his surprise, do you then dare to call your schooling a pest and a sorrow? Why, you graceless young varlets, I do not seek to free you from schooling. I do even now seek to bring you speedily the teaching you do so much stand in need of. Even now, within the week forthcoming, the good Dominie Luck, the tutor of mine own household, will see to the training and teaching of this town, and so I will warrant to the flogging, too, of all you sad young rapscallions who even now by this your wicked talk do show your need both of teaching and of flogging, and then, forgetful of the boy's thanksgiving offering and in high displeasure at what he deemed their willful and deliberate ignorance, the here governor turned the delegation into the street and hastened back to his waiting dinner. "Ack, so," cried young Toyny Vanderbreets, as the disgusted and disconsolate six gathered in the roadway and looked at one another ruefully. "Here is a fine mix-up, a regular Salmagundi, Patem Onderdink, and no question. And you did say that this Thanksgiving was all our work. Out upon you, say I. Here are we to be saddled with a worse master than before. Hermanus Smeeman did tell me that Nick Stuyvesant did tell him that Dominie Luck is a most hard and worryful master." There was a universal groan of disappointment and disgust, and then Patem said philosophically, "Well, lads, what's done is done and what is to be will be. Let us eat the Salmagundi anyhow and cry, confusion to Dominie Luck," and they did eat it, then and there, for indigestion had no terror to those lads of hearty stomachs. But as for the toast of confusion to Dominie Luck, that came to naught. For Dominie Aegidius Luck proved a most efficient and skillful teacher. Under his rule the Latin school of New Amsterdam became famous throughout the colonies, so that scholars came to it for instruction from Beaverwick and South River and even from distant Virginia. So the Thanksgiving of the boys of New Amsterdam became a day of mourning, and Patem's influence as a leader and an oracle suffered sadly for a while. 5 years after, on a sad Monday morning in September, 1664, the little city was lost to the Dutch West India Company and, spite of the efforts and protests of its sturdy governor, the red, white, and blue banner of the Netherlands gave place to the flag of England. And when that day came, the young fellows who then saw the defeat and disappointment of the here Governor Stuyvesant were not so certain that Patem Onderdink was wrong when he claimed that it was all a just and righteous judgment on the here governor for his refusal of the boys' request for no school, and for his treatment of them on that sad Thanksgiving day when he so harshly rebuked their display of gratitude and lost forever his chance to partake of Patem's Salmagundi.